they've talked the whole night through.
Good morning.
Good morning to you. Good morning. Good morning. It's great to stay up late. Good morning. Good morning to you.
When the band began to play, the stars were shining bright.
Now the milkman's on his way, it's too late to say goodnight.
So good morning, good morning. Sunbeams will soon smile through. Good morning.
Hello. Okay, everyone, it's 8:57. No. 8:58. And you know, today it's going to be a live broadcast on YouTube. So we have 2 minutes more, and then after that we have to behave. okay? Yeah, you have to look good, sit properly, okay? Show your best angle. When you ask questions, don't just, you know, smash your hand into the air. Go beautifully. Yes, I have a question. Okay, so let's get into the hall. If your friends or your family members are not here, ask them to come in. We are starting in 1 minute. Okay. Can I have one AMHM volunteer to come to the front and help me do the timing? One AMHM volunteer.
Good morning to you. Good morning, good morning. It's great to stay up late. Good morning to you.
When the band began to play, the stars were shining bright.
Now the milkman's on his way, it's too late to say goodnight.
So good morning, sunbeams will soon smile through. Good morning to you and you and you and you. Good morning, we've gabbed the whole night through. Good morning to you.
Nothing could be grander than to be in Louisiana.
In the morning, it's great to stay up late. Good morning. Good morning to you.
I'd be just as zippy if we was in Mississippi.
When we left the movie show, the future wasn't bright. But came the dawn, the show goes on, and I don't want to say goodnight.
Don't say good morning.
Good morning. Rainbows are shining through. Good morning.
Good morning.
Bonjour.
Bonjour.
Buenos dias.
Muchas gracias.
Buongiorno.
Buongiorno.
Good morgen. Good morning to you.
Volunteers, can you please ensure that everyone is sitting in the hall? We're going to start right now. Okay, so it's important for me to tell you that there's one booth at the back. Focus on the family. It's right at the back, and every time you have a break, a lunch break, or a little bit of time in between or after, please visit the booth. There's a lot of resources for you to use. AIA is also setting up their booth, and they are one of our kind sponsors. Tempo Sharp, a company who has given us some juice sachets. So they are also a sponsor, and if you haven't got your Tempo Sharp juice, go get it at the back, the sachets, okay? Okay, so third Archdiocesan World Mental Health Day. You know, welcome everyone, and give yourselves a big hand for getting here and being a part of this. So, I need you to get your phones out. Can you get your phones out? Okay, don't switch it off just yet. We have, take a photo of this. From the screen, take a photo. Oh, I mean, not of me. Okay, take a photo of this. This is our link to the live broadcast that's happening right now. So send it to your family group, send it to whoever. Okay, Everybody's got a photo of this? I want to go to the next slide. This, take another photo of this. This is very important. Next year, there's not going to be an Archdiocesan World Mental Health Day event like today. We're going to give you 10 events. 10 events throughout the whole year. January, February, right up till October. All kind of topics, professionals coming to speak. Remember, 26th of January, art therapy, my face. Come for it, okay? And remember, this one is not just to take and keep, take and send. Okay? Now, so it's very important now, if we have the next slide, it's very important now for you to switch off that phone. Okay? Because it disturbs so much. Everybody, so many people, not just one, when it starts ringing. And it disturbs you, so. Okay, so the Archdiocesan Mental Health Day has used the theme, Unity in Diversity. United we stand and divided we fall. Okay, and this is to focus on the family and to focus on the connections that we make. And it's a reminder about being gentle and considerate to one another. World Mental Health Day has chosen the universal or the worldwide theme of young people and mental health in a changing world. So for AMHM to focus on the family is very apt. Okay. So today you need to plan to have a useful day. And that also means plan your toilet breaks, plan your lunch breaks. Okay, so the morning is heavy. We have the plenary and a Q&A, and very quickly we need to get to our workshops, then is lunch, and then when you come back, there will be a lot of time for the questions and, you know, concerns that you have about the topic and the talks of the day. Okay? So now, I have to pronounce this word every year we have this session, this event. Can I introduce our ecclesiastical assistant, Father Philip Chua, who has graduated in philosophy and theology from Taiwan Catholic Regional Seminary. He has a registered counselor license from the Board of Counselors in Malaysia because he has graduated in his master's in counseling from HELP University. And he's a certified behavioral consultant, singing bowl therapist, choice and reality therapy, sexuality consultant, and currently is serving in our church here in Holy Family Kajang. And I would like to welcome Father Philip to give us the welcome speech. Father Philip.
A very good morning to Your Grace, Archbishop Julian, all friends, distinguished speakers, our brothers and sisters in Christ. We thank and praise the Lord for this beautiful day that brings us together this morning, for us to grow in our love for Him and for ourselves and for one another. My dear friends, we all come from a family. A family is a place where we learn to grow, to understand and meet each other's needs through care-seeking and caregiving behaviors. As you know, time has changed rapidly, and men's understanding and the ways of living out their family lives have changed. The challenges that come with this development will be different from those of the previous generation. I'm sure all of you agree with me. Admittedly, the church does not exist in the vacuum or void from such challenges and influences. Couple or marital issues, addictions, parenting problems, care for the sick and elderly, problems which stem from single parents, and mixed families where one of the spouses has remarried after obtaining annulment from the church are some of the family life challenges which require our urgent attention. With this realization and much discernment, the Archdiocese of Kuala Lumpur has decided to focus its words of mercy on families and youth at Archdiocesan level as well as parish level. For the Archdiocesan Mental Health Ministry, we have been reaching out to couples, youths, families by providing counseling services through our counseling centers in the Archdiocesan Pastor Center in Pudu, Holy Family Church Kajang, and all other counseling centers in the diocese. Our counseling centers provide services such as individual, couples, families, and career counselings, just to name a few. I'm also very glad to inform you this morning the Mental Health Ministry is in the process of training about 40 mental health helpers of various language to cope with the high demand of mental health services in our parishes. Our desire is to set up our first respondent team in parishes to help parishioners with mental health issues with a voluntary basis when professional help is not available during such emergency. Archdiocesan Mental Health Ministry has also assisted other ministries in the Archdiocese, such as the Archdiocesan Family Life Ministry in the program, as well as ASAYO as well. Furthermore, a new development in psychological as well as behavioral sciences has given glimpses of hope to deal with mental health issues, especially those related to families and marriages. So my dear friends, some of the exciting development in couples and families therapies that we can look forward to, like the integrative mortality where pure form practice of family therapy has become a reality and the less disjunction between individual and family, where interventions and theoretical precepts derived from individual therapy are used in conjunction with systematic perspective. As Christians, we place our faith in God, like in Psalms 119 that says, "You are my refuge and my shield. I hope in your word." We must also seek help from mental health professionals from our psychological problems. We may feel fearful or ashamed to see a counselor or mental health therapist when we are struggling with mental health issues, because in our society, when we talk about mental health issues, it's still a stigma. It's still a stigma and taboo for us. But the more we procrastinate to do so, my dear friends, the more serious the problem becomes and may affect the qualities of our daily lives, especially in families and in marriage. I would like to take this opportunity to encourage those who are afflicted with mental health issues to seek help from mental health professionals, as they are properly trained and they abide the code of ethics. Although the church is a closely knitted community, we assure confidentiality and privacy in high regard as required by the code of ethics. I would like to give a special thanks to Your Grace Archbishop Julian for supporting this ministry from the beginning in 2015, October, when we have our first high tea that we gather together, all our mental health professionals together, to start this ministry. Let us give a hand of applause to our Archbishop for your support and for your prayers as well. Finally, I do hope and pray that you and your families will greatly benefit from the talks and workshops which we have planned for you today. Thank you for your time and your participation. May God bless each one of you and your loved one abundantly. God bless. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Father Philip. So 4 years ago, very recently, our Archbishop celebrated his fourth anniversary. And I suppose the question is, have we felt things happening? Have we felt our church moving? And if you have, can you please give a big show of support in clapping your hands? So last year, he said, people have put aside judgment, fear, and stigma to come forward and focus on mental health. Can we invite our beloved His Grace, Archbishop Julian Leow, and give us the opening address?
Amen. That doesn't look like me, huh? That's the left, right hand, right side parting, huh? It's different, it's left side. Anyway, a very good morning to all of you. Father Philip, our distinguished speakers, I think most are here or on the way. Our mental health ministry members, all those in orange, and all of you who have come here, parents as well as young people. Mental health. We may think it only affects, as statistics say, 1 in every 4 adults or 1 in every 5 youth. I guess that's the strict definition when we talk about mental illnesses, schizophrenia, bipolar, dementia, the main ones. But it's also interesting in that list, anxiety is also one of these illnesses. And who doesn't get anxious? All of us. So we are all in this category of needing to look at our mental health. Because what may begin as just anxiety, panic attacks, may develop into serious illnesses if we do not have coping mechanisms in our lives. All of us go through stresses each day. Why do some seem to cope better than others? And I hope during these days or this day, you will encounter, you will deepen your understanding about how to be resilient in today's stressful environment. All of us go through stress. If you look at the picture, my hair is all white already. Huh? And how do we cope? How do we go through life not stress-free, because we will never be stress-free? Stresses, challenges, panic attacks, anxiety, depression, all these things are at our doorstep, or we may even be going through these challenges. The important thing is to cry out for help, to know where to go for help, and how to cope with these challenges. If we keep quiet, if we think, like Father mentioned, it is a stigma to be associated with mental illness, we we only have ourselves who will suffer even more. Therefore, I urge all of you, if you are going through anxiety and all the other things that are associated with mental illnesses, to seek help. To seek help and to help others around you too, to cope with these challenges. The statistics are frightening. 1 in 5 young people. And they say there are over 800,000 persons who are going through mental illnesses. And 10% contemplate suicide. I don't know whether you watch on TV recently, this football player in UK, I can't remember his name. Anyone saw that? They were sharing about mental illnesses in sports. They were great athletes. They were balanced people. And yet, many contemplate suicide. Many contemplate suicide at the peak of their careers. And these are people who have everything. So, my dear friends, let us today don't think that these things do not affect us, because they do. And the sooner we become aware, the sooner we say, yes, I need help, the sooner we are on the road to recovery and to cope and to be resilient to the storms that this life throws at us. So, my dear friends, I wish you and the team all the best as you organize these talks, as you allow us to have skills to cope with the many pressures and stresses of life. I hope that we will always remember to communicate, with each other. In today's technology, today's world, we can be speaking to people halfway around the world. We can be in communication, inverted commas, with virtual friends, thousands of friends, and yet suffering in loneliness, because we do not have a real friend to talk to. Let us help our young people, and perhaps ourselves too, to build real relationships with real people that you can see and touch, that you can speak to, that you can minister to and be ministered also. Real people, real friendships, real friends. At the drop of a hat, at any time, will your virtual friends come to your doorstep to help you. It is the family that will be with us, our immediate family and our extended family, church members, community, different friends that you have. Let us build those relationships, strong relationships, so that we can help one another to go through the rocky patches of our lives. And the Archdiocesan Mental Health Ministry is here to assist, is here it's only a phone call away. So I wish you all the best as you celebrate this Mental Health Day with these sessions from our distinguished speakers. And I just like to acknowledge Dr. John Ben Loy has just arrived. Dr. Nicole Chen is here also, thank you. Dr. Yo Pei Li, on the way. And Mrs. Tan Eng from Focus on the Family, and Mr. Warren Tan is not coming. On the way, okay. So enjoy the day, be open to new skills, and do share in your workshops. One way to coping, to recovery from stresses is to speak about it and to share your experiences. It may help someone else cope, and to listen, and also to remember the greatest healer, our Lord Jesus Christ, the wounded healer. And let us not forget him in our struggles, in our journey of life. So thank you, Father Philip, for all these talks that you are organizing and all the work you and your team are doing. Don't forget to also seek help yourselves, those mental health ministers. You can only give what you have. If inside your gauge is empty, you cannot give. So make sure you fill up your own lives with what you are giving others. God bless you.
Okay, thank you, Your Grace. Now, Luke Ambler is an Irish football player. Photographers, could you come to the stage, please? So Luke Ambler is an Irish football player, and he lost his brother to suicide. So he started this group on Facebook. I think it was his brother's name, Andy's group. And it was, you know, to promote the group, he got people to do this sign that represented it was okay for men to talk about suicide or to talk about mental health. So I suppose today we want to say it's okay for everyone, and not just suicide, but it's okay for everyone to talk about mental health. So we have our photographers. No, we don't have our photographers on stage. Can we get one person to be on stage and the other one to come to the front? We're going to take a group photo, okay? And so I'd like everyone to, you know, make that sign. And I think, you know, live the message that it is okay to talk. Okay? Best angles, everyone. Let's take a photo. Okay, say cheese. The other word that makes you smile is say suicide. Say anxiety. Okay, do we have it? Okay. So the Mandarin character for listen is a symbol. I am an art psychotherapist, so I love symbols. You know, and Mandarin characters are symbols, but the symbols that they use are the ears, the person, you, the eyes, the undivided attention, and the heart. So that's the kind of listening we want to do today. Can I invite Dr. John Ben Loy, a U.S. licensed marriage and family therapist who holds a master's of theology specializing in counseling, from Tyndale Seminary, Canada, a PhD